वेरी गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. वेलकम टू दी वेलकम टू एट अनदर टोस्ट मास्टर. आई नो इट इज अ बिट साफ कंट्रास्ट टू लास्ट सेशन बिकॉज आई सी लॉट मेनी पीपल हैव नॉट टर्न्ड अप. बट यस, वी विल कंटिन्यू विथ दैट. स्टार्टिंग विथ विल स्टार्ट विथ प्रिपेयर्ड स्पीचेस फॉर टुडे. फर्स्ट टू कम So let me introduce today's evaluation panels. I mean, who are going to take up different roles. Toastmasters of the day is Rashmi Lankar, that is me. Tabletop Master of the day is Gaurav Berry, and I'm sure you'll come up with some very interesting table topics. Speech evaluator is Anusha. And speech evaluator for impromptu speeches is Aditya. General evaluator is Satish. Heart counter is Ajay. And grammar aim is Devapriyo, followed by timer timekeeper is Sasan.
Tell me of the word of the day, everybody.
So moving on, we will like to have the word of the day.
It's obnoxious.
Obnoxious.
So obnoxious is basically something that is extremely repelling, extremely irritating, that kind of thing. Something that you are completely revolted with.
So, as you know, we must use the word of the day, because as many times you use the word of the day, you are going to receive applause from all the Toastmasters present over here. So that is what we follow here to keep the enthusiasm going. Moving on, we would like to start with Anshika. Is she present there?
Anshika is not there.
Okay, so Vasundhara, so Ritika.
Can I be second?
It's okay. Ekta. Yeah. You can start with the. You're starting with your. Icebreaker. So we welcome you to Toastmasters session, and this is your first speech. So the dais is open to you. You can start.
If you want, you can take the mic. Otherwise, if you're comfortable. Yours is the first speech, right? The icebreaker.
So my name is Ekta. I'm a second year student at IPM. The topic for the icebreaker which I chose was basically introduce yourself. And as easy as it was, it took me an embarrassingly long time to write something out, and even longer to gather the courage to come up here. I'm 19 years old. When I was younger, my parents used to move a lot. As a result, my brother and I were both born in different continents. My brother is 4 years older than me, and despite the vastly different physicalities, we used to have the most horrid fights. He stands around 6'4" tall, and I'm a stumpy 5'3", and try as I might, I could never reach him to throw in a few punches myself. Now, were any of you wrestling fans?
Yeah.
Any of you were? We were big fans of that growing up back in the 90s when there was a huge WWF, ECW craze. And being the younger sibling, I thought I might share this. I thought there might be some other sorry people like me who could empathize. Being significantly lighter back then, I had the fortunate experience of being thrown around the entire room, as my brother used to practice most finishing moves on me. Fire drivers, stunners, everything. Despite these incidents which seem more burned into my brain rather than being fond memories, my brother is my hero, and I admire and love him to bits. And if anything, I think he taught me to be a little more resistant to pain. A lot of people see me as the mousy person who sits in the corner seat and doesn't say much and doesn't socialize at all. And it wasn't always like this, really. There was a time when I used to be the person who basically could not shut up. But back home, I had the good fortune of being surrounded by people who had very similar tastes as me. We used to cite TV show quotes and movie spoilers and everyday chatter. And we were cool kids on show and on. Coming here was really tough because I'd never been away from home for more than a 4-day school trip. And being away from my family, who are the most important people in my life, was truly a difficult experience. But more than a year into the program, I can safely say that I'm truly happy. I've got a nice group of people who make me laugh, and when I'm at my best, that's more than I could have asked for. My hobbies include reading, and fantasy is one of my preferred genres. My favorite books include the Lord of the Rings series by J.R.R. Tolkien. Anyone heard of that? And I think he's a legend, an absolute legend, and I honestly think it's a shame that some of the more recent juvenile fantasy books playing on tragically impressionable adults and girls have surpassed this epic trilogy in printing records. And that juvenile series will remain not named. I'm a huge TV and movie buff as well, and I state that after having realized that I have watched more than half of the IMDb top 250 films of all time. I really enjoy gaming as well. That used to be another reason why my brother and I used to quarrel so much. He basically taught me how to play at a very young age because he wanted someone to play with, at the same time being easy enough to beat. But having practiced for long enough, I can confidently say that I'm the better of the two of us now. He might never admit it, but I know I am. I have no idea what I'm going to be pursuing on the career front. I don't even know what I'm going to be doing next week, let alone after 4 years. I've always had considerable issues in public speaking, and a lot of people have been kind enough to point out incessantly that I have a very funny or odd way of speaking. And we're all pursuing a career path where we're going to need to make a lot of speeches and presentations, and I'm actively looking forward to ways to better myself in that area. I'm excited about this opportunity to improve on my speaking abilities and overcome my fears for lectures. Thank you.
I don't know why people say you have a funny sense of public speaking, but I found it completely immaculate. I mean, it takes lots of courage and guts to come over here the first time and speak so fluently and so courageously. So, hands up to that. Next to come is Ritika. She is also giving her icebreaker speech, I suppose.
Yeah.
Since this is her first time, so let's give her a big round of applause.
You just need to switch it on.
So to start with, I would like to define life. What is life? According to Oxford Dictionary, life is the condition that distinguishes animals and plants from inorganic matter and other activities like movement, reproduction, etc. To summarize, I would like to state few points that constitutes life. Life is a gift, accept it. Life is the most beautiful gift that one can have. We tend to complain whatever life has given to us, but we hardly acknowledge the fact of the happiness we gain out of it. Life is an adventure. Dare it, make it, love it. Every morning when we get up, we should think life as a new journey to accomplish certain tasks and to complete the deadline, to fulfill the deadline. Life is a mystery unfolded. If one knows everything well in advance, there is nothing left in life to lead to. So the gift called life should be unwrapped layers by layers in order to seek surprise. Life is a game played. Everyone plays this game called life in his own way. Some play in an enthusiastic way, some can't stop being sorrowful, and others are indifferent. So when we have to play this game, why not to play it happily? Life is a struggle, face it. As it is being said, happy things come in small packages, and so does life. The different aspects of lives are small packages, and we need to strive hard in some of the aspects, and that's the time we should show life that yes, there are 1,000 reasons to smile as well. Life is beauty, praise it. We tend to curse life for all the bad things that happen to us, the hardships, the struggles that we face in our life. But how many of us actually thank life for its good things? How many of us thank God daily for its beautiful gift? Life is an opportunity, take it. This favorable time called opportunity is not being offered to everyone. But when it is being offered, I think we should take the best out of it. Life is sorrowful, experience it. Who says life is a bed of roses? Along with roses, we get thorns. So we should adjust to all kinds of situations. There's a book called The Secret. Everyone might have read it. It says, whatever you think more tends to come to you according to the law of attraction. So we should think more of positive things in an optimistic way so that happy things come around us. And in last, life is a mission, fulfill it. So to sum up, I would like to say that this four-letter word called life is a very peculiar word. It can make you go crazy. It is so soft that even if you speak about it, it can break. And at the same time, it's so strong that it can bear all the despair of the world. The life goes so fast that you don't realize how much time have you lost. Sometimes it can make you feel conquer the whole world, or sometimes it can make you feel a loser. So in the end, I would like to say, as the quote goes, life goes on. Thank you.
Well, one thing I can say, she is very much obnoxious about her life. But when she was talking about life, I was reminded of the famous dialogue. You must have seen the movie Kung Fu Panda, where Master Wu Kuei says that yesterday is history, tomorrow is mystery, and today is the present. That is why we call it today is the gift. That is why we call it a present. So I really like her approach to life. So next to come on stage is Pratibha. Okay, it's fine. So is Edna the? Okay. Any of the previous names who have not presented that, like
Anshika is here.
Anshika?
Yeah.
You can.
You like it? Guys, round of applause.
Wasted such sublime words over a bottle like Rahul Gandhi, you all must be thinking now what I'm actually up to. I know most of you, for most of you, he's a youth icon. But you should not refrain yourself from a grilling trip of Mr. Rahul Gandhi. Rahul Gandhi, representing the youth of India. He was charged for raping a girl named Sukanya Devi, who happened to be the daughter of Congress worker Mr. Balram Singh. On 3rd December 2006, Rahul Gandhi raped Sukanya Devi along with his 7 friends, including 4 foreigners. And look, today, he's roaming all free and even held in great esteem by all of us. Let me now explain you in the context of Delhi gang rape case. One of the noticeable fact in this case is the speed with which the Delhi police has actually acted and even managed to round up all the culprits who were involved in this case. One of the main reasons can be the outrage among the common people, but the main reason behind their action was that most of the culprits, I mean all the culprits belonged to the lowest strata of the society. They were the ordinary citizens of this country. Had they been the children of some rich and powerful politicians, their administration would have now been working towards clearing their names. The molestation charges against SPS Rathore could never be proved, and he got away with a little help from his friends in the government. Manu Sharma, son of Congress politician Vinod Sharma, was acquitted for the murder of model Jessica Lal. With much hue and cry that followed, the judgment was overturned and he was actually sentenced life imprisonment. In 2009, Sharma was allowed a parole of 30 days to attend to his sick mother and maybe other matters as well. But his mother was found later attending public function, and Manu Sharma, well, he was busy partying in the nightclubs of death. Recently, a BJP leader, Yogesh Atre, was arrested in North Delhi for raping a girl. He even threatened her with dire consequences if she ever disclosed their relationship with anyone. I'm a resident of UP and I've witnessed many such cases there out in UP. One of them is the Sheetal Birla case. One of the politicians, Bhagwan Sharma is his name, he's commonly known as Gudu Pandit, and he raped a girl named this Sheetal Birla. But the court set him free. And wait, not just that, he was even given ticket by Samajwadi Party, the present party, governing party of UP, to contest in the MLA elections of 2011 and 12. This is the power of the rich and powerful in this country. Police is at their beck and call. Lots of cases go nowhere because of the tact like BJP, Zimmer Congress, Samajwadi Party attest with these cases. Well, it is all about the political system of our country. But let us now talk about, you know, the mentality of the common people, which is the main reason behind my pessimism. According to some people, we women, actually we have, you know, forgotten our traditional wearing and we are wearing nasty clothes. So they think that because of all these wearing of our hours, rapes are the obvious consequences. So these men want us to believe that women are getting raped because they want to get raped. Well, God save us. And yes, with this mentality in mind, they then suggest that women should actually learn karate roll so as to safeguard themselves against rape. Well, can anybody tell me what can a woman do if 4 men pounce upon her? Well, the time is over.
It's okay, you can cut it.
So we kill women before birth, after birth, and keep killing them even up when they grow up. It is not at all surprising that women grow up with a demented mind, polluted mind, and commit heinous crime like the one in Delhi. But what has happened is the sheer reflection of the Indian evolution. women being raped day in and day out is the story of Indian evolution. For the Indian scenario, all that I can say is, hum gamzada hain, laaye kahan se khushi ke geet, denge wahi jo paayenge is zindagi se. Thank you very much.
Yeah, that was really powerful speech, but one thing I would like to point out that Toastmasters actually forbids us to make comments on religion, sex, politics and all, so you covered all that.
Anyway, I'll take care
from there. It's okay. So, I mean, that was really powerful speech, but I will leave everything else to the evaluator.
It's okay, I mean, we are the flexible here at all. Traditionally, all this would have been slightly, you know, propagandish, but thanks.
Do we need to be politically correct?
Sorry?
I mean, in Toastmasters, do we need to be politically correct?
Not really. We can have our own opinions, but yes, I mean, let's just keep it subtle, not very...
not in the public.
In general, profanity...
It would have been better if we from our side would have mentioned it from the front. But anyways, I mean, great speech. Next to common stage, I don't think anyone else from prepared speeches who have nominated themselves are present here.
Pratibha and
Vasundhara.
Yeah.
Pratibha can come.
Yeah.
And next, Vasundhara.
Childhood of a man. These fill one smile with joy when one looks back to the days of childhood. When I look back to the days of my early childhood, I do not remember much. I was sitting and thinking, which of the memories I have is the brightest and most joyful for me? Is it the day when I went to the school for the first time? Yes, indeed. That day was equally joyful for my parents too. I went to Modern Vidya Niketan, Faridabad. It is considered to be a very reputed school, so my parents decided to send me there. It was a new life to me, but I liked it very much. I made a lot of friends there. And then suddenly I realized how time flies. Yesterday only was my first day at school, and now I find myself finishing school life. I was very excited also because since high school, I curiously waited to enter college, a place filled with fun, freedom, and of course education. A number of individual perceptions are linked to campus life. Undoubtedly, this is one of the most important phases of student life. But transition from school to college is not at all easy. Because when you first move to college, you're going to be in a new place, handling new situations. You may be living with someone you've never met before. You may be introduced to different types of people who you may have not been associated with during high school. The first time I got the taste of college life was when I entered Miranda House. It is widely regarded as a premier institution for women. I was always very much interested in astrophysics, so I decided to apply for physics honors there. There were diverse activities outside the classroom learning, including clubs and societies. I became independent and learned a lot of things there. I enjoyed every bit of it, but that place was never meant for me. I was destined to go somewhere else, and this somewhere happened to be IIM Indore. Getting into IIM is like a dream come true. I feel quite happy being in this place. I have very good friends here. I am more outgoing and talkative when I am with them. But when strangers surround me, I am more shy and talk much less. I like listening to music, reading and dancing. My hobbies include making cards and collecting coins. And one thing more, I am good at reciting alphabets in reverse order. Do you want me to do that?
Yes. Yeah, sure.
ZYXWBUTSRQPONMLKJILGFEDCD. I don't know what to talk about myself. I'm also very, very nervous. So next time I'll try my best to give a better speech.
You done?
Yeah, I'm done.
So why don't you keep the paper and talk for another minute just about yourself?
Okay.
You know?
You ask me questions, I don't know what to talk about.
Anything about you, you know, like, let's say, you can describe your one
your
year
hobbies,
here.
You can talk about your hobbies.
Your experience so far, you know, you were talking about a lot about your campus expectations and all those things, so. It's okay, just try.
Something about your hometown.
Okay. Okay, I hail from Faridabad. It's near New Delhi. And I did my schooling from Faridabad only.
How do you collect your coins?
No, only coins, not different countries' coins.
Yes.
If I want to buy something and it costs something 2 rupees, I give 10 rupees and collect those 10, I mean 8. I mean it's my hobby, I don't know, 5 rupees.
Do you collect different varieties of coins or
not different varieties?
Okay, could you very quickly spell your name backwards?
This is difficult. But I'll try. A-H-B-I-T-A-R-T.
Well, Ansika was telling that she can read out the letters backward. I was reminded of the engineering days when seniors used to rag us with certain words. When pronounced backward, it would create a very derivatory meaning, but then we were forced to read it backward. So, that was more difficult. So, anyways, moving on, we'll...
Good evening to everybody. I'm from IPR 2011. Life is like an ice cream. Eat it before it melts. What I have learned from my life experience, let me tell you what I have experienced in my life. I was born as youngest child in my family. I was so stubborn and naughty, and then I have so much experience about my life. First thing was I feel so lucky because I have moles in my whole village. Only I have moles, that's why I feel I'm so lucky. And I was a person who couldn't live without my parents. But unfortunately, from 6th standard only, I have to leave away from my parents. And I have got memories during my childhood, I was so fascinated about geometry box. And every time I used to ask my father to bring a new one. But I never got it to use whole. Because whenever I get new one, I have two elder brothers. Both came with proposal new one is very bad and old one is much better than old new one. And they were able to exchange that. And every time, again they give back me old one and take new one from me. This was the bad thing what they have done with me, because they never let me use the new one. And I was big foodie from childhood only. If I'm eating, nothing matter what is going to happen in this world. One memory, once I was traveling in my train with my parents, I was eating and by that time I fell down from seat. Everybody thought I'm going to cry, but I didn't cry because I was eating. I got up and again I start eating, and after some time when I finished my eating, I start crying. Everybody asked me why you cry. Then I explained because I got hurt. whenever I get anything, I always try to get whole thing for me only. Because of that only my brothers used to hate me. Because of that only once what happened, nobody was there at home, only we children was there. They took me to one dark room and after that they leave me there alone and they bolted door from outside. And start asking me to accept their condition. I would not take whole thing again and again. But I was so stubborn I didn't accept their condition. And for 1 hour, I was didn't accept. And these people didn't open the door. And finally, when my mom came after 1 hour, then only get out from room. This was my ultimate condition of stubborn and my. And one thing is that I always, whenever somebody used to ask me who loves you more, then I start counting my cloth given by everyone, and finally my result goes to that person who has given the highest number of cloth to me. I was so fascinated about cloth and anything new. But everything stopped this when I got in Navodaya in 2004. I was so determined to get in Navodaya. For that, I started preparation in 2003. And always I prayed to God, see really how I could get in Navodaya. And but my happiest moment last when I get in this Navodaya, because after 2 days only I feel like everything is going to end. I don't know how I am going to survive for 7 years in this world, and everything was like so strange for me. But and for that I start making different drama and to get out from the. I used to cry a lot, and I have one friend who always support me, and we both planned every time to support each other to before teacher, then anyhow we can get holiday to go home. But it never worked. I used to come with different variety of sickness. I faint here and there, and it was that frequency that was high. Anybody could understand why I'm doing all this thing. And I never got excuse because of that. Then I thought, this is not going to work. Let's start with natural thing. And for that, I start like in winter, I don't wear sweater. Then I could get cold, and then these people will send me home. But everything stopped when in 9th, and everything changed suddenly in 9th, because that friend who supported me before that, she migrated to other Navodaya.
You can still continue. Yeah.
Everything stopped, and I got a good friend, and I start studying, and after that from 9th I start enjoying my hostel life, and we used to make Maggie and all these things. We used to stole rice from mess anyhow and make something with that, with snacks and all these things. And one thing I want to make front here, that we have migration from South India, JNB Kerala, some district, and these people are, no offense to anybody, but I have got impression from there, that South Indian half life is full with coconut oil only. So they have been that much only. And I was so depressed, if I go outside, how can I survive with this South Indian, because they put so much of coconut oil. But thanks to IIM, after coming here, most of my friends from South India only, and they are not like that, I don't know from else. But here when first time I came, that time I was also scared, because I got room with my roommate who don't know Hindi, and I didn't know English. I thought, I am going to survive again from this Navodaya, come again this another Navodaya, surviving in this world is going to be hard. But anyhow, now we get used to that. And one thing I can't forget, and any Navodaya can't forget, we get everything free. And after coming here, whatever you get it free, you use it full, because where we get free but we don't use anything, because it is coming. We deserve this, and it's coming, we don't. But after coming here, for a small thing also, for sports also, we have to give money. That time I feel really so bad, ki why I couldn't, use that what I got there. That's from there I learned that whatever you get free, you use free. Because I think in further life, I'm not going to get anything else.
Basandhara, I also agree that all good things in life should come as free. Who likes to pay for that? Moving on, I mean, except Toastmasters, I mean, you have to pay. But then, it's a good investment of your time, it's a good investment of your money. as I said that, I mean, look at all. I mean, we are all here to improve ourselves, and we're all here to listen to each one of us. So, I mean, it's a great time. I mean, just 1 year, just 1 hour of every week, and we learn so much from each other. Without further ado, I leave the dais open to the tabletop master, Gaurav, and he is going to enthrall us with lots of innovative table topics for today. Gaurav.
Okay, after so many introductory speeches, let's move on to the impromptu speeches. I think it would be more interesting. Just reminding you about the rules of the impromptu speeches, you would be given 30 seconds to think about the topic, and then 2 minutes to speak.
Okay.
We have 6 people in the impromptu speeches. Without wasting any further time, I would like to call Nivedita.
I'd like to come next, please.
Okay. Abhi Jama.
Gaurav's already got the devilish smile.
Okay, the topic for you is your dream bike or car.
Start the speech by admitting that I'm not much of a vehicle person. Given a chance to either, you know, walk or hire a cab, I would most probably walk, provided the destination is within my reach. So, if given my dream bike or my dream car is out of option. I'm not much of a driver also. I have tried learning to drive many times, but I have always failed. My younger cousins, they are much better driver than I am, and it sometimes puts me to shame when I am the, you know, passenger and they are actually driving the car. So in case I have to pin my thoughts on the bike I will buy, if given a chance, it would be a Firefox bicycle, not a bike in its children. Firefox bicycles are considered to be best in class. In addition, their gears are quite sturdy, and the thing is that you can drive it on any terrain possible. And